Today, we're going just to make a French press. So sorry, I forgot to introduce myself. My name is Regine, and I'm the head of coffee of and the roaster of French Mission Torréfacteur, or French Mission Roastery. So today we're going to do a nice and tasty French press to share with your family, friends, and loved one. And we're going to show you how to make it simply and not bitter at all. So for this, the first thing you need is Juju here, my assistant, lovely assistant, and she's going to have a preheated French press, a preheated receptacle for the coffee, a spoon, coffee, and the coffee from French Mission Torréfacteur, freshly roasted. You don't want something roasted for like 4 months ago. You want something freshly roasted. And if you do not have a grinder, ask us to grind your coffee slightly coarse, okay? And the water. The water is not boiled. The water is heated between 92 to 96 degrees, okay? So for that, either have a thermometer or simple have a control temperature kettle. Or what you do when the water enter ebullition, stop there at that time, okay? So remember, we at high altitude, ebullition here start at 89 degrees, all right? So now you have this, we're going to start. So our French press is already preheated, and to keep the heat, I put a cloth around it, so it stay nice and warm properly. So now what I'm going to do, this one is a 1 cup, you can see it's preheated. Juju is going to add water up to here. Go, Juju. Okay, perfect. Put it on the cloth. Fantastic. Add water. And stop. Okay. Now close it. All right. We need a stopwatch too. I will just tell you why. Now you're going to take a good spoon of the coffee with your measure spoon. A good spoon, and please show to the camera. Okay. So just be generous. Come on. Voila. Okay? Close it. Perfect. And put that spoon into it. And as soon you put it, you put your stopwatch on and you don't throw it. And you stir. Okay, to make sure that all the coffee is into your coffee. So when you stir, it's just putting all the coffee in and three stir. That is it. You don't need to stir too much. Mm-hmm. That's it. Perfect. Okay. And now what you're going to do, your stopwatch is already on. You're going to put the piston in and you enter your piston just to keep the coffee underneath the water. Push, 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 push. Leave it. Perfect. And you stay. Okay. And you leave it hot. Okay. So, what we did, we have our stopwatch set at 4 minutes because it needs to be brewing for 4 minutes. As soon you put the coffee in, you start the stopwatch. Always put the water first, then the coffee. And the reason is really simple. If you put the water onto the coffee is going to be stuck in the bottom. And most of the coffee on the bottom will not brew. So you want to brew all your coffee. So first water, then coffee, then you stir 3 to 4 times. You don't need to agitate it like a maracas. And after you put the piston in order to keep your coffee underneath the water, then you let it brew for the rest of the time until you arrive to your 4 minutes, which will be soon. So we just put it on pause and we see you in a minute. Okay. All right, we wait. So now We almost at our 4 minutes. At 4 minutes, when it rings, you're going to see what you're just going to make, to do. 3, 2, 1, go. So Juju, push the piston, okay? Be careful. And empty the whole coffee into that decanter. The decanter has been preheated in order to keep the coffee brewing. So the reason why she's doing this is really simple. As long as coffee is touching coffee, the coffee is extracting and it's going to be bitter. To avoid to be bitter, once the extraction is done, we remove the whole water from the coffee. So now, like this, we have a nice and beautiful coffee which is not over extracted. Because what's going to happen? People who have the coffee here have technically water. Here it will be bitter, and there it will be just really dark and not very agreeable and pretty bitter. So we don't want this. This, we use it only once and that's it. Now, what we're going to put on our table to impress our guests is our preheated receptacle with a nice brewed coffee, which is not over extracted. So means which is not bitter. That's it. So if you want to learn more about how to make good coffee at home without having a brain injury, don't worry, just contact us. The address is just below there on the screen. And see you soon for more coffee adventure. Bye-bye. Quoi, Eric?